I just proved it works. The setup crowd here is 1,600 odd people plus. All the fights are amazing. I'm going to have a pretty hard time picking a fight at night.
One of the things you guys do incredibly well is the timing. How important is that production crew to putting on an event of this size?
Yeah, everything's done through military position on the show. You know, there's an allocated time slot for every fight that's on that card. We run plus of 5 minutes over. We may have little hiccups here and then, but it runs on time.
This was the first Super Saturday. What are your impressions of this first of many?
Amazing. It was amazing. You can feel the atmosphere in here tonight before the fights even started. You know, and it seems to be that the fighters rose to the occasion of what went on. Every fight was amazing. The knockouts, the TKOs, the submissions. Like I said, to you already, fight at night, I'm going to have a pretty tough choice there. I think I'm going to have to do out a few fight at night bonuses.
Can you see Super Saturday taking place outside of London in the future?
We've kind of started here. We passed that question when it comes, maybe next year. It all comes down to the schedule, what country we're in.
And what about the Channel 4 deal? Obviously, that got announced recently. Were there any other stations in the running for a broadcast deal for KKR, or was it always Channel 4?
There is another station in the running. We're apparently with Channel 4 for now. 2015, who knows what happens.
You talked previously about you're going to announce a date for your debut in Sweden next week, and it's going to be in Stockholm. And are you sort of, what kind of time frame are you looking at? Closer to winter, or sort of third cycle, fourth cycle? What do you think?
We'll be there before mid-September.
Before mid-September.
That's the most I can give you.
Okay.
It'll be before mid-September.
Going back to Channel 4 deal, how many shows will we get for a highlight show before you go live?
The Channel 4 deal in Cage Warriors, we're dating. It's a date, you know, we're going to see how we get on. If we get on really well, then maybe live for the whole of 2015.
Yeah, Marcin Rosak came today, fought Arnold Allen, who, you know, was undefeated on Cage Warriors. His kids come in and shock the world. Can we expect perhaps a new signing?
He's signed, I want him. Yeah, we're going to go after him. Yeah.
And what about Rosie Sexton? After her fight today, it was enough a tough night for her today. Yeah. Do you think she should maybe call it a day today?
That's a decision for Rosie to make. I'll certainly have a chat with her during the week and see what she wants to do and where her head is at. Yeah.
Jack Marshman said that potential Chain Mills in September. You like that one?
It's a nice fight, huh? You want a job?
There were a couple of decisions that weren't quite as unanimous as it might have been portrayed. Were many decisions in particular that you're displeased with?
Judges, I don't get involved. You know, I paid to bring in these judges. These judges watch the fights. They call them as they see them. It's not for me to make any judgment on what decisions the judges have made and what they've saw. You know, I'll watch them back tomorrow. Sunday afternoon, I'll sit down and watch all the fights again. I'll have my own personal opinion, just like you and everybody else. But the judges were here to do a job. They got paid to do a job, and that's what they've done.
If it wasn't before, Cage Warriors is certainly the premier European event now. Are we looking at Mexico, the States, or are we going to consolidate over here first?
No, we'll be in the States by the end of the year. We've got Mexico lined up, Australia, and all the usual places that we have on the world schedule already. The plan is, moving forward, we'll be hitting 2 shows in every country that we go to. So 2015, we'll be hitting 24 shows.
You talked towards the end of last year about the Four Nations tournament.
Yeah.
Has that been put on hold at the Channel 4 deal, or when can we expect to hear news of that?
Four Nations tournament is going to happen. It's a timing thing, and there's a lot of planning goes into the Four Nations of what we're trying to put together. Hopefully, now that we've got a little break for the first time in nearly a year and a half, we've got an 8-week break of shows because of the World Cup. There's no point in us doing anything with the World Cup on. So while we have that 8 weeks away from shows, we'll start developing the ideas of the Four Nations and everything else is going to go along. There's also this CWC Academy, which we've also got more or less done. We'll announce that probably next week.
There were a lot of very strong welterweight performances here. Do you think there's any fighter in particular who might be next in line for Nicolas Dalby?
Yeah, that's already done and dusted. Yeah, and it was nobody tonight.
Is it Danny Roberts?
It's not Danny Roberts, no.
What's next for Danny Roberts?
Danny Roberts will come back probably September. He'll take the summer off, and I think he's back in probably September in Wales. Yeah. Against who? We don't know yet.
Obviously, the last show, you guys had to come out with a pretty hard stand on fighters making weight. How pleased are you with the fact that, you know, this show you didn't have those issues? And do you think it's because you took that hard line?
Yeah, absolutely. We brought in, at the start 2 years ago, we brought in 2.2 allowance, 25%, anything above that 40. To make things 150% clear, I never want to take any money from any fighter. None of that money that is deducted from them, if it is deducted, goes to their opponent or goes to charity. It worked. Everybody's on Wade. Two guys went over, they agreed to catch. It sent the message out loud and clear that we're not going to accept it. So hopefully it moves forward that way.
You've recently...
Yeah, we've got 20, I believe we've got 29 professional female fighters signed to the roster. So we've got some ideas where we're going to do weekenders over the next 12 months. And those weekenders will be Friday night female fights after my Cage Warriors on. So just to give the girls their one night of just the girls.
What about the amateurs?
I can't hear you.
I heard something about an amateur tournament kind of thing.
Yeah, it's Cage Warriors Academy. We'll be developing amateurs to nurture them into the ranks of Cage Warriors and the prelims and the warm-ups.
You've mentioned about an event in Birmingham. Do you know when that'll be? And is Tim Wilde now going to be a focal point for that?
Tim Wilde's a beast, huh? How good was that fight? Tim Wilde is a... But you've also there, you've got Dave Hill, Tom Breeze. They're also on the roster, so that'll be a big card. And we'll probably do that... last 2 months of the year with Birmingham. Yeah.
With more cards next year, are you looking to obviously expand your roster and announce some more fighters for Cage Warriors?
Yes, of course, yeah. We'll be bringing a lot more international fighters. I think Cage Warriors right now is probably one of the biggest European e-manor promotions as regards activity and schedule. I think there's 180-something exclusively signed fighters to the roster now. So we'll be adding to that.
With the Channel 4 deal, what is the first indication going to be that the Dublin card looks different, and have you decided who will be the two main eventers to get the who'll be first to get the added exposure?
We haven't got that far yet on nailing that card down, but we will this week. There'll be a lot of title fights for the Channel 4 dates that we're going to have. So I think every show on Channel 4 will have a title fight, and there may be a tournament chucked in as well.
And just to ask, obviously it was one of the first things you did when you took over Cage Warriors, but would you be looking to return to Cork in the future?
We will at some stage, maybe next year. There's a lot of cities, a lot of countries we're visiting. Cork was a good spot. Only problem with it is it's furthest past Southern Ireland, so all the boys up north don't want to travel all the way down, so Dublin's a good meeting point. But maybe yes, depending on the schedule next year.
You talked about the women and the women's division. There's a fight that, you know, after watching Joanna fight tonight, I mean, that girl is special. Is there any chance we might see her in a Gnusk anytime soon? Because we know there's a little bad blood there as well.
I honestly think after her performance tonight, you might not see her at Cage Warriors again, but
yeah.
We'd like to have her here, and we'll talk to them during the weekend. If that's possible, we'd love to keep her here, yeah.
That'd be a tasty
yeah,
fight.
Yeah, she was amazing. Yeah, she was amazing.
There were quite a few upsets tonight, a few underdogs that pulled it off. Which underdog were you most impressed by?
I think the Joanna Rosie fight was the biggest upset, yeah. I thought Rosie would close that distance, and maybe our grapple or our experience would do that, but Joanna on her feet, her hands were just lethal, you know? She was impressive.
So a lot of people are going to be looking at this and asking whether Rosie should hang it up. I know you made comment earlier, but how great, whether she retires or not, how grateful are Rosie for helping develop the division that you're going to take forward with Cage Warriors?
Yeah, Rosie will have a job with us. You know, Rosie will work with Cage Warriors and help to develop the female side of the organization. Yes. Yeah.
You mentioned earlier about Dublin.
Yeah.
The former Cage Warriors champ, Conor McGregor, headlines in Dublin for the UFC.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts on him selling out the event in about 3 minutes, I believe?
Conor's awesome, man. You know, Conor's got... We spotted Conor as the X Factor when he fought in Dublin. You know, he came out, the whole place was singing, waving flags, and he rose to the occasion. He just grew and got better from there. The guy's... I hope he rises to the heights that I think he's going to go to, and I'm chuffed for the guy, and I hope he does really well in Dublin.
And will you be going over to watch him in that fight?
Will I be over to watch him? My nephew's getting christened the same day, so no, I won't be in Dublin for that. My sister wouldn't allow that.
It's a little bit tongue-in-cheek, but you know, you got Ian Dean as your matchmaker. He must have worked his backside off to pull this card together. How often are you looking for the cards like this? Is it just yearly at the moment, just the one every year here?
As the promotion grows and the organization grows, I mean, bear in mind, 3 years ago, we were three cardboard boxes, okay? So as the promotion grows and the divisions get deeper and deeper, then we look to put on these type of events. But this was a special occasion to bring out every major gun we had to give the fans a big sending off before the World Cup started, and it worked. You know, it was awesome. I mean, look, look at all you guys in here.
Grant, I was ask you about Jack Hermanson's performance tonight. Obviously an excellent performance, but going forward, not to discredit anyone, the middleweight division wouldn't be as stacked as the Cage Warriors' lower weight divisions. Do you feel that is an issue, and if so, how do you, are you going to be working towards addressing that?
Yeah, I'm going to look to, we've got a few more middleweights to announce who have just signed with us, so we'll be bringing them in to the occasion in the next maybe 7 to 10 days, and I'll look to rebuild that. We're also finished putting together a light heavyweight division. That's going to come out. We've got maybe 7-8 guys are going to be announced as signed with Cage Warriors end of the week, maybe start the week after. Got a few more contracts to get back, and then we'll let you all know.
Possibly another tournament?
We won't do a tournament just yet. We'll let the guys settle in. You know, we'll let them get a few fights in Cage Warriors for us. We'll see who rises to the cream of the crop, and then maybe put a tournament with other guys who are at the top. Yeah.
Kind of selfish question, you know, we've been to Cage Warriors in Swansea, we've been there in Liverpool, we've been here in London. When are you going to hit the Midlands up?
Birmingham. End of year, last 2 months. Last 2 months of the year, we'll be in Birmingham.